Hey there, and welcome to this course on these scales. Wow, you are in for quite a ride. You will use these scales, you learn them here, you will use them forever. They will be a part of you, you'll completely ingrain them, and they will be something that you do on the guitar through the end. It's quite, they're a partner and a journey for life. So congratulations, you'll form a deep and lasting relationship with them, with all the ups and downs that any relationship inevitably brings. So a couple of notes before we get started in things. First off, this is kind of a big project you're undertaking here. While there are eight basic shapes, basic patterns that we'll learn, you know, each of those patterns uses quite a lot of the guitar. Some of them use, you know, the entire guitar. And so, and each one has its own little issues and everything. So I would say be patient. Know too that you can start this, get a couple of shapes, practice them for a while, come back next month, whatever it is. There's no obligation for this. And also, I will also say this. Keep practicing tunes. Keep practicing music, because nobody wants to hear your scales. As delightful as they are for us to play as guitarists, nobody wants to hear them, you know? You invite your people over, they don't want to hear you play your scales. It's sad because we put so much work into them, and it's very impressive what comes out at times, but they don't understand and they don't care. So keep playing real music so that you have something to play for your people or the cat or your dog or whoever, just yourself, and then use these as part of your technical exercise. With that said, also, you want to continue, while you're learning these, continue to do your existing technical work. So hammer-ons, pull-offs, arpeggio patterns, all these things. Don't stop everything and just focus on these, because there's a learning curve, just like learning a new piece, that will come with learning these patterns, to where you won't be actually doing technical practice. Once you memorize the patterns and start practicing them, then it will become technical practice. But until then, it's kind of on par with learning a new piece. It's not a substitute for your other technical practice. And so keep up the other stuff and approach these as if learning a new piece, which is basically what you're doing. You're learning new notes. As you're learning this, the main point is to memorize the patterns. So get off the sheet music or the grids or the tab as soon as you possibly can. The goal here, your very first job, is to memorize. That is job one. Before hand position, before the right hand does this, whatever, it's your very first mission on these is to memorize the patterns. Because from that, you can actually then focus on other things. So that's job one. As you learn them, job two is be patient. Be patient, be patient. These will, if you're not used to playing up and down the entire fretboard, you will likely experience a little bit of confusion and frustration sometimes, and because things can get just, as you memorize, you know, if you don't quite have the patterns memorized and you're moving and all of a sudden you find yourself way up here in no man's land, and then it can be very disorienting as you start to move more along the neck if you haven't done much of that. So be patient. If you really get to a spot where you're getting emotionally involved, back off and play something else. Do something else. Go for a walk, practice some other scale shapes or some exercises or arpeggios or play a tune or whatever you want to do. But don't get bogged down in them. You've got plenty of time for these. And the last thing I'll mention is that it's worth your time to go slowly in learning these, because you'll learn them faster if you actually go slow and learn them right the first time. So the fewer mistakes you make, the faster you'll memorize and the faster your muscle memory will come to be for all the things. So go slow, make sure that you're doing it right, and make as few mistakes as possible. This is, in general, a good practice when learning things as a matter of course. But I'll mention it again here. It's just a better way to go. Be methodical, be deliberate, stay focused while you're doing it, and have fun. Enjoy it, because they are wonderful and they're a lot of fun. I'm very excited to get along with it, and let's do it. See you in the next one.